Good evening, football fans, and welcome to the National Sports Center for the Richard Hector QC Memorial Football Cup between the accountants and the lawyers. This annual game has been going on since 1999, and today we are looking forward to another spectacular match. I am Andrew Painter, your commentator, and my co-commentator here is Enrique Parsons. How are you doing today, Enrique?
Good evening, my beloved football fans, and I am wonderful, Andrew, thank you.
So, as I look down there, I'm looking at this Lawyers team, and they have a pretty good squad. I mean, half the players look like they could be a part of Bermuda's national squad. Would you agree?
Yes, I do, but don't sleep on the accountants. You never underestimate your opponent.
And we are here, moments away from kickoff, and just so happens that the heavens have opened, the rain's coming down, and the match is underway. The Richard Hector QC Memorial Football Cup. I would say that the accountants are looking to come back into the match this year with a vengeance, as they got badly beaten last year, 8-3 by the lawyers. It was a very one-sided affair.
Woo, what a one-sided affair it was.
As you see the slick hand, the slick ball movement early on, and the accountants are going up. The accountants have gone up.
I told you, that magic.
Early on.
That rain magic.
Michael Belay works at PwC. Has gotten the accountants off to a flying start.
And I told you, do not sleep on the accountants, Andrew. Just now look at this.
Oh man, we have barely had a chance to take our seats, Enrique, and already the ball's in the back of the net. But here come the lawyers straight from kickoff, and he's just ran it out. I can't understand that one.
Well, that's one negative that comes with the rain. You can't see.
We give him the benefit of the doubt, even though it is raining very lightly, folks, but we'll give him the benefit of the doubt. As we did say before, this is our annual cup in memory of Richard Hector, a former lawyer from Guyana.
Yes, indeed. And he left Guyana more than 35 years ago to take up an appointment as Crown Prosecutor in Bermuda. He was later promoted.
And here's a cross, and it's... Oh, they ran close!
Oh, and Jahan with a wonderful save.
I think that was supposed to be a corner just now. He got away with that one.
Jahan Sedino came to play today.
As I take a look around, I'm looking at the water building up on the side of the track. I would say the National Sports Center has some excellent drainage. As Mark and Warren touches the ball and passes it to Jasmine.
That girl has quite a touch on her. Keep your eyes on her, folks.
Sedino out to Killian. As the lawyers are just knocking the ball around, as he looks for Antoine Russell long, but he fluffs his kick and it goes all of 10 yards before it's intercepted.
By Mr. Kelvin Hall.
It's always nice for these so-called charity events.
Yes.
And what a ball! A lobbing pass over the top.
And that
the header is blocked by the keeper, and it is tapped in.
Number 7 from the accountants, Mr. Paul. I say. Paul seemed to be amped up before the game, Andrew. And my.
There must be something in the water at KPMG that they're giving him.
Oh, yes.
So the accountants are off to a flyer. 2-0 up inside the opening minutes.
Did you say something about revenge, Andrew? Because...
And look at Jasmine with the foot skills as she passed it out wide.
Ever so elegant.
Killian picks it up, a Bermuda National Squad player, and loses the ball. And here come the accountants on the attack again. Wonderful body movement by the Loyal defender. They go long looking for Antoine Russell, but the pitch
and
is a bit fast.
And Blaine Beansball almost finds Antoine Russell. Nice vision, but he has to keep in mind, Andrew, that it is wet, and that ball will dance all game.
Jasmine makes a great pass to Antoine Russell. Cuts out wide, and his shot is blocked by the defender of the Alcones. And Jasmine takes a hit, and what a good one with the header to clear it out of danger.
Mr. Jeff Bungie.
I think you was right, Enrique. Jasmine seems to have a bit of skill to her.
Oh, yes.
She looks to receive the ball short, plays it back to Russell. Goes across one player to Killian, who squares it to the top of the box, and the shot is fluffed again by Marco.
The accountants brought all the defenders today, Andrew.
Well, accountants like to crunch numbers. I wonder if they can crunch the Lawyers' attack.
By the looks of it, this game will be a high scoring one.
Well, this game usually produces a lot of goals. If you look at the very first one in 1999, the Alcones won 9-1. That game being played across the street up at Police Field.
Oh boy, talk about a derby. If that's not something new, I don't know what is.
The very next year, in the year 2000, the Alcones won the match 5-2. 2001, the Alcones won 4-0. So the Alcones do have history at winning this annual event, even though the Lawyers have gotten the better of them in the last two occasions, winning 7-4 back in 2014 and 8-3 last year.
The Alcones want to take back what's rightfully theirs. And what a way to start.
So, Enrique, what would you have given these players as advice before the game if you were the manager?
Don't dive in. That's the only rule I would tell my team.
Okay, that day someone will get embarrassed if that happens, that the ball goes long and great bring down on the chest and an excellent ball down the line. He takes a look up, passes in the middle, a little too hard.
And Tawana Tanak. With a steal.
The shot from long, but it was a quite easy one for the goalkeeper, Jahan Sedino, who is Jamie Sedino's son. So there's a bit of a family affair going on.
And that must be the moral booster because both came to play excellent football. And I must say, the Lawyer team is knocking it around so good, but they just can't seem to find the net.
Well, they say every great team has a great defense, and this accounting team looks like they came to win.
We are nothing but championships.
Mark has to cross into the box to Killian. Can he pull one back?
And
off the
what
line.
A save.
A clearance off the line by the defender of the accountants as Jasmine bips in a dangerous ball.
And the defense again. My.
As this is end-to-end action early on, the goalkeeper left on the ground scrambling.
But John Donnelly made sure he was there to have his goalkeeper's back. Exactly what I would want from my defense. Kudos to you.
Must have really came to play because even if this Lawyer star-studded team, they are up 2-0 early on. And look at this, more penetration on the right flank. He looks to cross it over. It's a good cross. Finds his player, and it's number 3.
What a wonderful goal.
3-0 early on.
10 minutes in, Andrew. 10 minutes in. And we already have a ball game on our hands. And it looks like the Lawyers are making substitutions. Oh, boy. And the manager is up out of his seat. He's not too happy.
No, he's not too happy at all.
He's not too happy.
It's raining. He's got his work clothes on.
What a wonderful goal by Markel Wolden. calm, composed, great finish.
I would be mad too if I was the lawyer's manager. Mr. White, out there in his wet clothes.
And it looks like Tawana Tanik is coming off for Shakir Smith.
And
it looks like they're warming up two more subs, Andrew.
Yes, they are. But if Shakir Smith on the field, another former national squad player, I say the lawyers are rolling the dice right now, down 3-0 early on. As you have Killian with the ball, feeds Antoine Ross with the one-time shot.
Just wide.
Snapchat it a bit.
Yes, they pull it. One, another thing you have to watch out for in the rain, Andrew.
The hard and loose shots?
Oh, yes. Skits just like a rock on water.
You see the goalkeeper play a short to Trot, the accounting defender who plays it long. That's Corey with the ball.
Oh, what fast feet.
Ooh. Oh, off the woodwork. The curling shot off the far post. Left the keeper stranded in no man's land.
I must say, Paul is having an excellent game. An excellent game. Proves to be the danger man up top, Andrew.
Look at him again. Always anticipating the pass.
The lawyers better wrap this up quick and do something because our conscience looking to repeat. Looking to repeat that 9-goal driller. That's Bean. Poor clearance from Bean.
He loses the ball. Looking for Corey, but the didn't just get to him easy enough. Slow it up a bit.
Nice attempt from Bailey.
He looks up at the keeper of the line. And has one and sails over the bar. Good effort. Some 40 yards out. He must have thought he was pulling skills just now.
Ha ha ha.
Well, mate, you're not. Good effort.
And now, folks, we have a football game.
As he goes along looking for Russell again, he tries to chase the ball down to Killian Elkinson.
Just quite doesn't make it, Andrew.
Enrique, I was up here watching Killian play left back for Bermuda the other night against Dominican Republic, and he was actually one of the outstanding players in that team that day, even though Bermuda lost 1-0.
They look like they could have used him up top, Andrew, because he's having a wonderful game up top for the lawyer team right now.
Looks like they could have used Corey too, as he killed his marker down the line and sent over a delicious cross for the attackers, but they couldn't quite finish.
And the lawyers are having a slow start to this game. I don't know what's gotten into them, Andrew. This is not the same team that won last year.
And if you're just tuning in, the Accountants are off to a flying start in this Richard Hector QC Memorial Football Cup as they are up 3-0 in the 13th minute. Yes, you did hear it right. 3-0 in the 13th minute. If the lawyers aren't careful, the Accountants are going to turn this 3-0 score into a cricket score, as they would say.
Andrew, I would not be surprised.
Here's the through ball, and he was well offside. How do you think the players have fared so far, Mr. Parsons?
Well, it looks like the lawyers had a long day in the office. They just cannot seem to get their head right. The Accountants, on the other hand, oh my, how they just love numbers. I hate to say I told you so, Andrew, but I think the Accountants will wrap this up quite easy.
Well, you're calling the game pretty early on, anything can happen.
Yes, and right now we will need for the lawyers to wake up. They are sleepwalking.
Well, these lawyers have to defend criminals in the court of justice. I hope they do a better job at that than they are doing right now on the football field. Because if they're not, down, I would say that that skate's probably full right now. What do you think, Mr. Parsons?
No, we're looking mighty, mighty fine on the streets. And let's just say, I'm glad they keep it there, because if I have to watch this, let's just say, Andrew, I have faith in the lawyers. As they continue to push and push, the accountants are standing firmly together as all accountants do.
And a wonderful switch of play, but it is cut out by the lawyer defender, Jeffrey Elkinson, who is Killian's dad. So there it is, another family affair. So we have Jasmine looking to find her way through the middle, but is intercepted, maybe through her dribbling. And he just ran over the ball.
It's wet out.
But he's recovered very well. Picked it up, took a look up, and a great pass. He finds his man. As the accountants are just looking to knock the ball around. It's trot again with a ball in the middle to the accountant attacker. He was pushed down in the box. Takes a look at the ref. The ref thinks he went down a bit easy.
Paul Martinez, such a vital bit piece for the accountants up top right now. It's making them tick. And it must be running down to the back line because the whole team is ticking. My.
Foot skills by Killian. And the back heel to Warren from Antoine Russell, which was smartly cut out by the accounting defense. This accounting defense just seems like they're on point, they're organized. As another dangerous cross comes in and another beautiful cutout. Everything that the lawyers threw at the accountants didn't seem to be working right now. Another clearance off the line. Folsom, ooh, just over the bar.
Magnificent tight defense down the back for the accountants. Girls win games, but defense wins championships. And accountants have them both.
Bet they do. I mean, compared to last year, this is a great improvement. Again, if you're just tuning in, this is the Richard Hector Memorial Football Cup being played here at the National Sports Center. Brought to you by Crimson Multimedia. As the accountants are looking to get their hands on the trophy that they haven't touched for 2 years. Because the lawyers have been that good. As Antoine Russell drives the team forward. Gives it the body fake. Passes out wide. Into the box. And it's a shot. And a good goal. It took a deflection and the ball skidded off the ground. And into the back of the net.
That is the magic of the rain, Andrew. The magic of the rain.
I mean, it came off the ground like a bullet.
And this just may spark up the lawyers. Big moral booster. They need it.
The score now is 3-1 to the lawyers. I'm sorry, to the accountants. If the lawyers just scoring. A well-taken goal that the defense almost cut out. And we have a match on our hand. As that girl puts the lawyers right back into it. And Antoine Russell with another great ball.
To a
stormy
Marco
cuts his defender good far post. Shot. Looking for Killian, but can't quite get him.
Lawyers just can't catch a break.
The lawyers have Jasmine Spence in the midfield pulling all the strings.
And it's wonderful to see a female playing with the males. And who says women can't compete in a male sport.
I say gender equality.
Yes, gender equality is right.
As the accountants go forward again, but the lawyers are starting to look more confident as they knock the ball around his market, picks the ball up, plays a short to Russell. Russell gives for one, some 30 yards out, but again just scuffs it shut. Is he trying too much? He definitely has the ability. He is an outstanding Robin Hood striker here in the Bermuda Football League. I believe they finished runners up and captured the FA Cup.
I believe you are absolutely right.
Again, they must be thrilled to be playing here at the National Sports Center, Bermuda's ideal venue.
In honor of a wonderful, wonderful man. And look at this, Andrew. Hector also represented Guyana on several occasions in the 1950s, and he performed a remarkable feat when he built Sir Leighton Hewson. He was, at that time, the best batsman in the world for a duck at the GCC Grand in Georgetown. Georgetown.
Look at that. He was a football fan, a cricket fan, and a great lawyer.
And a great, great human rights activist.
That's not to mention he was a great man. All around.
Very all around. Kudos to you, Mr. Richard Hector. He must be so proud of what his legacy has become.
It's a wonderful event to have in his memory. As Killian showing off for some of his skills. Great 1-2 with Antoine Russell, skips across two defenders. And the ball was inches wide. It looked to have taken a deflection and went off for the corner, which the referee eventually calls. As we have Russell running over to take the corner.
A slow start for the corner, very slow start for the corner. But they need to take their time. Oh, and a good ball in the penalty spot. Cleared once again. Only cleared as far as 30 yards out. As he has another shot. Tries to dance around, but the accountant was not having that.
Russell with the cross to Marco. He flicks it on. And Cedinho, on the edge of the six, manages to hit the woodwork.
Impossible. What possible miss?
How the heck did he do that? You don't see that much.
Oh.
Not even on video games.
Well, Andrew, the rain is coming down now and...
Four. He should have scored.
Smith right off the toe. What a wonderful ball wide to Mr. Waldron. Mr. Waldron dances.
Lays it off at the edge of the box. As Johnny flips it on.
I must say, Paul John are having a wonderful, wonderful duo of a time up top.
We have Jasmine again, carrying the ball, showing her skill. And a wonderful pass to Marco. He skips across his defender.
What will he do?
Cross another one, but...
And skips right outside for a goal kick. My.
Jeff Bungie stood his man up very well just now and forced him to go one way. This was out.
The lawyers need more teamwork going forward, Andrew. And that's the accountant's strong suit. Teamwork.
As you have Shakir Smith storming down the line, but he loses the ball. Again, to Dunley to Montero.
for the wonderful effort. And that's all it was, her effort.
Jasmine picked up the loose end and passed it to Antoine Russell.
And the lawyers come back down.
Looks for Russ at the edge of the box. As he passes it back out wide, what will he do? He has a lot of time on the ball. Looks for Alkinson. As they are just knocking it around.
The lawyers just can't seem to find the opening. They cannot seem to pick the accountant's lock. What will it take?
It's an all-star team, but they're losing.
Egos, my friend. Egos. As they build up slow from the back.
Chris Smith.
As the crowd urges the lawyers to pick it up.
As I was able to pass from Tokyo Russell, looking for Antoine Russell, his brother, but couldn't find him.
And Donnelly. Nice vision, but couldn't quite find him.
Lena playing a short to Tokyo. Tokyo trying the no-look pass to Killian.
Almost found Justin Ross was there.
Wonderful pass. And almost an own goal there.
What?
I said it once tonight and I will say it again. What the heck is going on?
The lawyers just can't seem to get right. And the accountants are making a sub. Tom Corey on for Paul Montero. And he's had a wonderful, wonderful run up top.
Wow, the last name like Montero sounds Colombian. He should be good.
Found the net a couple of times, and hopefully he'll be looking to add more to his telly. The lawyers just look completely lost coming out from the back.
Like I said, I attended this game last year and it was quite the opposite. But the lawyers are so potent in attack and the accomplice are looking deflated as the wayward pass by the country midfielder since the lawyers are throwing in their half.
We can see who really truly came to play today.
Take my hat off to these guys because they have knocked off from whack that came up here to the National Sports Center for this annual cup game in memory of Richard Hector, and it's raining.
Passion. Passion and love. Name of the game.
I bet you some of the wives are here mad right now. This is cuddling weather and they're out here playing football.
Hey, Andrew. Where I come from, football is your wife. Your first true love.
Oh, there you go. There you have it. From Mr. Parsons himself. Killian Elkinson.
Yes.
The edge of the box cut out again. But Marshall
strong,
Warren
mighty defense.
Scrap. Goes to Russell, crosses it over. Picked up from his brother Tokyo, who drops it back in.
Mr. Jack Bungie is being a rock down the back today.
There's a little shove in his back just now, but the ref obviously didn't see it.
Jack Bungie has the defense tuned right in today, and they are not having any of it.
Russell to Warren, who uses the ball, and is cleared again by the opponent defense. Wonderful way to hit off the ball.
Wonderful touch by Tom Curry. And he's off again.
Look at him good. He's looking like Usain Bolt out there. Who would have thought he had it in him?
Who would have thought?
Not me.
My. The game starts to settle down. It looks like the lawyers have awakened.
Wonderful ball to Russell, who brings the ball down like a champ looking for Alkinson in the middle. But again, it is cleared out by this opponent defense.
Calvin Hall from mighty fine slide tackle. Mighty fine indeed. I must say,
having a great game.
Oh, Bungie has got the back intact. Intact.
And as we look, the lawyers are making a substitution. Coming on the field, number 8, Tristan Hall, replacing Tokia Rossi.
Left the pitch. Who would have thought? Up in it and still running like a young man. Passion and love, Andrew. Passion and love. Interesting, the first touch.
And a great pass it is. Warren. The outcome. On the edge of the box. Just throws his marker. Looks for the shot.
Smith chases it down. Slow build up. That's been the name of the game for the Lawyers.
What a ball. What a cutout again. As it falls to Marco. Plays it to Hall. Back to Marco. Looks for the opening. Slides in Hall. And it has to be a penalty. It must be a penalty.
Indeed it is. Great call from Mr. O'Neill. Great dancing by Russell to win the penalty. And I believe Russell will take it.
Or did he dive like a certain Ashley Young would do for Manchester United?
I highly doubt that. Defender thought he was going one way. He tricked him, bent the other.
And here it is.
Right from under him.
Taking the penalty. Russell. The Robin Hood hitman. Bermuda National Squad player sporting the number 9 jersey. And it's a goal.
Well taken penalty. Well taken penalty. Composure level high. And he knew where he wanted to put the ball and put it there. Oh, Andrew. You have made me bite my words. And the game is 3-2. And we have started all over again.
And if you're just joining us, it is the 33rd minute. The Accountants lead the Lawyers 3-2. But the Lawyers have came back from 3-0 down and bought themselves within one.
Now we have a ball game on out here, ladies and gents.
Oh, like I said earlier, this game historically...
What a tuple. Can they take advantage?
Good effort. As the ball goes up for a corner.
It's a Tom Corey. It's been dangerous ever since he came back on the field.
You see that? Soon as Jasmine comes off the field, they have trouble defending.
Scary save from the keeper, but he seems to have it all under control.
Shakir Smith sending his speed as the PHC man brings the ball down calmly. Looks for Marker in the middle, who's looking to carry it forward. Goes to turn his man and passes out wide to Russell. Skips across one marker. Takes a look up. Sees his man in the middle, and it is a poor header.
I must say, Andrew, he's had a tough half.
Yes, already. He has. He can't blame the sun because it's overcast, and he can't blame the rain because it's only sprinkling. What will be his excuse? Maybe he's just not good enough.
Ball goes out for Lawyers Grove. Looks like the Accountants have got a bit tired. As they have slowed down the tempo of the game, and the Lawyers pick it up.
What a goal!
Russell
what
turns
a goal!
And fires one into the back of the net.
That's Russell's second as he levels the scores. 3-3 from 3-0 down to 3-3, and it is the 35th minute.
Well, Andrew, you were right. I spoke too early. And just like that, the game is back level.
Well, I told you the game historically produces a lot of goals, and look at it already. Not even 40 minutes in, and we have had 6 goals already.
What a derby. They both won it so badly.
But who wants some more?
By the looks of it, the rain.
I would have to agree with you on that one. Well, my tank is certainly full and a wonderful dummy, but Marco to Russell, who crosses it over.
Russell's a wonderful
looking for his mate, and he gets one.
Yes, indeed. A wonderful dive.
Bite my tongue, he's had a crappy game, but that was by far the best goal so far. A diving header.
A wonderful cross by Antoine Russell.
Russell so far looking like my man of the match, scoring 2 and assisting 1. As the Lawyers go up 4-3 from 3-0 down. And it's still the first half. It is raining goals here at the National Sports Center in the 37th minute.
My. He almost looked like Van Persie with that diving header.
What a ball.
And it takes the flank.
But Shakir Smith says, not cross me, buddy, but he loses it in a crucial time.
Sloppy defense will cost them, as it has been all half.
And he should have really done a lot better. He is a premiership player here for the Pembroke Hamilton Club.
Must be the stadium jitters, Andrew. When you play up national stadiums, oh, they're feeling ecstatic.
I see our Conscience have a corner. And it's a good cross. Good save by the keeper as a rails to the top of the box.
Shaky clearance brings out a wonderful save by Mr. Johan Sardino.
Great shot there.
Even better save.
And there's another good corner.
Straight through the keeper.
And here comes the Lawyers on the counter.
What?
Good defense to slow him down a bit, but Russell just skips across him.
A ball to Marco Warren. Gets it under control and dances once again.
Russell gets the ball back. Marco with the shot.
He has
off the post. Killian.
So unlucky from Mr. Warren.
Sidini with the header. And wonderful football, but Russell trying too much. Tristan picking up the loose ends. Drives his team forward. Skips cross 1, 2, 3. Oh! And that would have been one for the highlight reel, folks.
Indeed. Now he reminded me of just now. A little bit of Neymar.
A little bit of Neymar.
A little bit. He must watch that good football.
And look at this.
And the conscience are off.
Great anticipation by the goalkeeper to come off his line early and block off the shot.
The attack is not done now.
As he tries to skip cross 2 guys, but again, Shakir Smith having a solid game at left back, but runs the ball out. Short throw into Trott. He takes a look up.
Puts the ball in, and the keeper's got it.
Sedina calmly collects as Russell screams for the ball on the other side of the field, and he gets it.
Russell dances.
Skips cross Trott, but Trott recovers.
Passes. Smith with a heavy, heavy touch from
I would have loved to have been out there today playing. I'm sure you would have too, Mr. Parsons.
Oh, yes, indeed. I love me a kick. And I love it for what a honorable course it is for. Once again, these men playing for Richard Hector.
Killian trying the chip from just outside the 18-yard box. A bit ambitious there. Again, this is the Richard Hector QC Memorial Football Cup here at the National Sports Center between the Lawyers and the Accountants, with the Lawyers going up 4-3 after being down 3-0.
And Mr. Hector could be proud about that, as he was a lawyer himself in 1964 of November. He got admitted to the Bar of England and Wales. In February 1972, in the 29th, he was admitted into the Bermuda NAR. He was elected president of the Bermuda Bar Association during AGM of the 8th April 1999, and again during the following AGM on the 27th April 2000. He served a 2-year term, and sadly, his life was cut short in the mid-70s, in February 2006, from a heart attack. Man. What a sad, sad way to end a marvelous journey of a life, Andrew.
Yes, indeed. And that's why we're here today, to honor his life with one of the sports he so dearly loved.
And who knows? Maybe one year they'll do cricket.
Who knows? I would love to see that. As Tristan Hull skips across two guys, plays the 1-2 of Killian Elkinson. Shakir Smith on the edge of the box.
And he has one.
Looking for the bending far post shot. Well, let's just hope in these conditions that the player's safety doesn't come at risk. As we go back to 2008, when the Accountants won 5-2. Mr. Larry Mossaden, the Bermuda Football Association president, broke his leg. As we take a look back at the play, and Killian Elkinson has a chance to score. The ball is on the line. The Accountants have no idea what's going on, and he luckily saved the ball from going in. But Larry Mustin broke his leg in the first minute of the game in 2008.
Wow. And I guess that's why he's the Bermuda football president today.
I say he should have just never played.
Hey, well, we all think we're a kid once you see a football. And I'm pretty sure he took it back when he was 15, but just forgot that his body was 65.
As Killian Elkinson picks the ball up, plays a lovely ball to Marco, who plays it back to Killian, who looks to score at the far post and does so as he widens the Lawyers' lead. 5-3 in the 44th minute, coming down from 3 goals.
What a wonderful first half we have had here.
It's been a cracker. 8 goals in the first half.
I don't know what happened to the Accountants, Andrew, but I think they have been asleep. I know the rain makes you feel nice and sleepy, but where have they gone? My, the Accountants need to work it out and make some subs. Let's see if they could turn this game around. And way back to the keeper, Mr. Scott Higgins. Playing on the behalf of the KPMG company.
Well, we all know that Mr. Higgins is no goalkeeper. As the Lawyers go close again, and he looked like he was in La La Land, the goalkeeper.
Like you said, Andrew, maybe he's a striker, maybe he's a midfielder.
I just think he's an accountant. Don't quit your day job, Mr. Higgins, don't quit it. KPMG needs you more than this football team does.
Oh yes, but he's got the right insurance for the right job.
So he loves to count numbers. He is an accountant.
Touch from Pete Robbie.
That's just him. He don't
Pete Robbie takes it down.
Let's just say Mr. Higgins didn't have to count too many girls against him.
I think he's done counting for the day. So we hope. Mr. Warren brings it down. What a wonderful long ball from Warren to Russell. And what
Russell
will he
just
do?
Let the ball run, looking for some more support in the box. As he looks for more blue jerseys. And what a ball to Shakir Smith, who doesn't read it properly. And Mr. O'Neill, the referee, blows his whistle and brings the end to a cracker of a first half. The Lawyers are up 5-3, having come back from three goals down. It could be anyone's game, as you can see.
Anyone's game, and the Conscience need to get in that room and pep talk and rally up the troops and come out swinging.
As we will be back after these messages for the Richard Hector QC Memorial Football Cup here at the National Sports Center, brought to you by Crimson Multimedia.